There, planner friends, and welcome to a super long overdue planner video. It's been a while. I seriously thought I would actually put something out during the holidays because I was really using my planner and it was being a really effective tool in helping me handle like all my life things, but I don't know. I was just busy living life, I suppose. So while I was not producing content here, I was keeping my Instagram updated consistently, pretty much, and I was also still using my planner greatly. And the main planner I was using was a personal planner. Now this is one I bought off of a lady I follow on Instagram last summer that you've seen a few times before. And I transitioned to this one at the new year because I just felt like a new start. So I emptied my Kate Spade and took everything out of there and put it into here. Now I did make some new dividers during the holidays from some clearance Target folders that I had. And using my favorite tabs, which are these index tabs by Avery. But we'll get to that later. So I was fully intending to use a personal planner in 2018 as well, because it really helped last quarter for school and personal and all that fun stuff. So let's get into this one first, at least how I set it up. And then we'll explain why my old bullet journal is still hanging around. So in here, it's a Kiki K medium personal. It's a little on the chunky side, which I honestly don't mind anymore because it has everything I need, or everything I needed. And I prefer this one to a Filofax I found because of the larger rings. And because it's the beginning of the year. I'd prefer to have like all of my inserts with me to take full advantage of the year to come. And here I have some degree pertinent stuff like my degree requirements, my road path that I set up with my academic advisor, all that fun junk. And here I have that $2 bill, some stamps, my sticky dashboard, and some more sticky notes, because I was also utilizing those really effectively when I was planning in here. I have this dashboard, which I purchased off of Etsy, and I'll post where, because I purchased from them a couple of times. You probably can't see with my crappy camera, but this is beautiful printing. It actually looks like leather, and all the colors are really popping. It's a lovely, lovely dashboard, and it actually comes in a set of two, so you have like bookends essentially. I do. Here's the other one. Don't mind that. That was just Christmas money that I'm hoarding. And then in here, I have a Target sticky pocket that I cut in like a half moon shape so that it would be a little bit more free and easy. And this is where I usually keep a stencil, because that's what I was doing last quarter. I was not using stickers so much, but using a stencil to like mark certain events that I had, or classes, because I was really getting into my color coding system. And I even started this year off with it really effectively. It really worked. The only problem with this system is that it's made for a different kind of schooling than I'm doing right now. So the reason why it worked last quarter was because I had a lot of classes. I was taking more than a full load. However, the teaching styles that I experienced during that period were fairly similar. They gave you the syllabi at the beginning of the year, or at the beginning of the term. And essentially you could count on pretty much everything on that syllabus materializing on the day that they specified. So I was able to plan ahead. So if we go over here, in my first divider, which is blank because I know what it is. It's school stuff. And this is from the academic pack from Joann's, or no, not Joann's, Michael's. So if we go here to fall 2017, you can see that I just, in the colors that I designated each class, I would put what my assignment was, and I could pretty much count on it. The only problem was a Spanish course I was taking, which had a ton of assignments, but again, they were on specific, stringent, not gonna move, not going to change or alter even if they cancel class dates, and that I just printed in a smaller size and punched, and I kept that along with my weekly insert, and I would just cross it off on that page, but I could count on it, and it made it easier. So I put it everything down at the beginning of the quarter, and then when I went to plan for the week, I'd refer to this list. And it was super nice and super easy. Now, I intended to do the same thing once my winter quarter came around, but it wasn't so easy to plan anymore because I'm taking so many courses again this quarter, and an extra one in fact, so way beyond a full load because I want to get out of there on time. And the teaching style is different. Instead of holding up the syllabi as the end-all, be-all, sacrosanct piece of writing, it's more a guideline. It's not firm. The dates aren't firm. It's more of an idea, a feeling. And beyond that, I have a ton more little assignments. So last quarter it was like a lot of readings, like read chapter one, read 500 pages, that sort of thing. And you know, critically think about it, do all the stuff you normally do, but it was a lot of literature-based coursework. This quarter it's a lot of linguistics and a lot of grammar and a lot of just project-based stuff, and I have a lot of teeny tiny tasks that will get lost in my whole planning system here if I can't write it down, and I couldn't write them all down. I mean, this was the first week and I only had classes beginning on Tuesday, so I missed the first day because it was New Year's Day, so it was a holiday. And still, you could see in my color coding system, there were a lot of tiny little tasks, and it was getting just lost. And I realized when I was planning for this week, there was no way I was going to fit all the homework on here. And it wasn't static either. I had to really decide whether or not I wanted to write the homework assignment on the day it was due, or if I wanted to like plan ahead and write it perhaps on the day that I was going to attempt to do it rather than the day it was due. And that was a thing to think about, but also it really depended on the space that I had afforded myself. And if the space wasn't there, then I couldn't write it down, then the whole system would fall apart and all that fun stuff. So despite the fact that I got the lovely Kate Spade 2018 inserts, which I purchased from her website, I think in late August, early September, right when I received my grant for the new school quarter, because I knew it was something I wanted to get done. And these are little Erin Condren tabs, and I really liked the way that the color system worked too. It doesn't always match, as you probably saw from the setup video I had previously with the Julio that I sold, because I don't know what I was thinking. I don't need an expensive planner like that. It was no better than this beautiful Kiki K. So I set it all up, and they're really beautiful, and I just can't use it for this quarter. I don't know if next quarter will be different, so I'm still gonna hold on to it, and my quarter is only 10 weeks, so I'll find out in late March if I can start using it again. And I hope I can, because I really do like the personal planner system. And I still have a bunch of stuff in here, like check registers, like car stuff, that I got an oil change on New Year's Eve, my ink inventories for my Signo pen, which is currently still kind of my favorite system. Actually, no, I went back to the Jetstream, like the actual Jetstream dedicated multi-pens. How frequently I buy food for my dog, my cat, it's like every other day or something like that. A hair tracker dye, I really need to update because I did something bad to my hair. And just some other personal stuff. Whoops. So, I really want to come back to this. And I even used some little Hobonichi papers, the Tomoe River paper, and copied the only thing I really enjoyed about the Happy Planner, and put it into each month so I could document that. So I think I need to move this away. And, oh, so cute. I'll put this in my current planner. So yeah, despite being all set, all ready to go, thinking that my system that worked so well for so long last year would carry me through into this new school year, my expectations were a little shattered. So let's go to the thing I'm actually using. I didn't have a ton of time to wallow in, oh my god, what am I going to do? My planning system isn't working for me mode, which usually includes, you know, many purchases, many trying of planner systems, and all that fun stuff. But 2017 was the year of indecision, essentially, for me. And I tried everything. I tried bullet journaling. I tried A5 with Inkwell Press inserts. I tried TNs, which I still love. I still have my full-size TN set up, and it's kind of like my creative sort of thing. Pocket TNs, which I also really like, but again, it was more useful when I had really specific assignments that I could count on. This system, this quarter, where I have a ton of little middling assignments and unspecified due dates, or due dates that you only really realize once you go to class and your homework and your professor just mentions offhand before the class ends, oh yes, that assignment, pages 4 through 10, and the exercises afterwards, those are due next class. And then you're like, ah, fantastic. So, none of what I had tried previously I thought would suffice or work in this new environment. So I went back to kind of scratch, to something I can manipulate, to something I could suss out for myself. And I went back to my bullet journal. This is the one I had in March, I think I began it. It's a loose term, 1917. It's a dot grid in Army, and it would have been helpful if I put the month. Yeah, I think it was March. So this is one I had back in March, and I used it until it was not convenient for me. So again, this was a time when I started a new quarter, or I was about to, so this is probably spring break. Yeah, spring break. This is the book list I needed. I made a little calendex, so I was all on board between my winter and spring quarter. But then I got to my spring quarter, and it was kind of like, I don't know, I just couldn't. I didn't function well with the kind of homework I had, again. Like, I couldn't figure out a system where this would work. So I kept trying to adapt my system. And this is like a post-it that I tried to do because I had one class that was throwing off everything. It was a lit theory class. And I had like a ton of readings due just like whenever we'd meet next. Not necessarily at a specified time, just, you know, whenever. And it didn't gel with the rest of my assignments that were very specific. So I kind of flailed around a bit, as you can see from these setups. Oh yeah, and then I bought this from Oddloop and I really wanted to use it. And I knew as I put each sticker down that this was a bad idea. But alas, what are you gonna do? And I'll tell you what I did. I didn't touch it for nearly a year. 9 months, 10 months. So I picked it up again. I was only on page 22. 22 is blank. I did fill some stuff out in here randomly. Let's see. I know page 100 is my reading list. My books are 2017. I have an actual copy of this, a filled out copy that I made for my personal planner. But I think I'm going to just reuse this, repurpose it, and make it 2018, just white out the titles. I also had sketched my desk, so I inked that up just a few days ago to help me kind of reassess my organization. But I didn't really like the bullet journaling system because I needed something to work immediately. And it took a lot of sussing out. And this is some recent hair dyes that I've done to myself, and in case I'm going to buy makeup. This was a brow gel that I really liked. So I needed something to work immediately, something simple, and something that I would have no problems taking out in class and like quickly jotting something down. So the first week I had this, I used my current favorite washi tape, which is something I got from Cute Things from Japan. I'll link their Instagram down below because that's the easiest way I have found to get to their store. And a new Tombow that I had purchased from Michaels because they have Tombows now. And I just did this really quick, so that I could kind of mentally as well as physically block off everything that happened in 2017. I then used the other mild liner Tombow that I purchased that same day I went to Michael's and just created a super simple spread. I was thinking this would be adequate for homework, and it kind of was, but because this was the second week of school, we didn't have that many assignments, to be honest. And just listing my tasks, like appointments and that sort of thing, and just other random stuff, I found this helpful. Still not the best use of space, but it didn't make me want to throw my planner against the wall and scream in anguish, so you know, good stuff. So I made a new Calendex. You'll see it kind of looks familiar, not only to my past Calendex, because I mean, how varied can you really get? But it also kind of mimics the color situation in those Erin Condren tabs I had in my personal planner, because I really liked those, to be honest. I'm not a huge, huge color person. I tend to stay with like muted tones, but I really liked the way that they all worked, so I mimicked that here. And I'm only giving myself about 6 months, because to be honest, even though I'm going through this a little slowly, I have a feeling that I might need a new one in April, but we'll see. Because I don't really plan out the rest of my pages. Perhaps that is the next step to planner piece, is fully organizing everything and having my yearlies and my monthlies and everything planned out, but right now. I'm just trying to survive this quarter where I'm taking way too many classes, so this works. And it's kind of the same principle as that monthly calendar I had in the back of my personal planner. Kind of the big ticket assignments are listed. So when I have midterms in my online class, when I have projects due for a multimedia class I'm taking for teaching, that sort of thing. The individual little tiny day-to-day assignments, I have nowhere to put those except for my homework tracker. So I'm keeping it simple again. After the first week that I took this to class, I realized a couple things. I cut off the tabs that I had left on here. They were pretty Michael's tabs. I'm pretty sure I still have some, but they were just getting folded over in my backpack, despite me kind of handling it, you know, just like a book, nicely but not too nicely. I also realized that I needed a pen attached to this thing, which meant I had to get the Loose Term sticker, and I got the gold one because it was cheaper than the army. It was also, I think, a nice coordinating color with the green. Like I said, I kind of like feeling the muted tones right now. So I made that adjustment. Also, this pen loop sucks just about as much as a Filofax one, so it's really limited in the pens it can accept. So I decided, since this was a bullet journal and I was trying to keep it simple with all the same pen kind of in my assignment section, that I would finally try out the Metropolitan fountain pen. And I like it so far. I like it a lot, actually. It also uses the same cartridges as my Pilot Kakuna, which is this little guy. I like this one too, and I still use it in my Hobonichi because this stays at home, but I don't like that it doesn't have like a clip. I'm using that with sepia ink. Lava, it's very nice. And I also have some sepia, or like really dark brown, kind of toned micron. So that's what I've been using to draw my spreads. So I made those adjustments, and they were really minor. And this week, where I had my Calendex, I had no tabs sticking out, and I had my pen loop. Was really, really helpful. I'm using Post-it still. And on Thursday afternoon after class, or no, not Thursday, Friday afternoon after class, this was filled with Post-its from class because, like I said, our assignments are kind of like haphazardly assigned. No specific date, nothing really to count on the syllabus. So when I got home, I just copied it down in my color coding system and put the assigned date and column where I can mark off that it's done. And I use Sharpie pens there. Of course, there is shadowing, and who knows if next quarter is similar and I need to continue bullet journaling in order to keep track of all my little tiny homework assignments, then I may consider getting a Rhodia or something like that, but for right now, this is working out just fine. And I keep all of these with me in my pencil pouch, which I'm still using. I haven't washed it yet. I feel like I should. It's been like 2 years. 3 years, maybe? I think I got this when I was still in community college, so at least 3 years. And I just started using Sharpie pens again because I was cleaning up my stash and I remembered how much I missed them, so there's that. And I'll show this shortly, how I planned out this week, but it's really simple. It probably looks simple, but I knew I wanted to track kind of what food I was using or eating just to be a little bit more mindful of it, but I didn't want that to get in the way of me like just cracking it open in class. Like, that would be distracting. So I decided that I would, don't know what that was, that I would just fold it in half and kind of use it like a Dutch drawer sort of system. Not really. So it's technically like a week on one page, but then you have your second page full of just personal things. Except my personal things are homework and food. And then it'll work for this week too, where I did the same thing. I'll tuck away the homework and, or I'll tuck away the food tracker and have the homework one. I think I am going to pre-plan here soon, March. I hope to have that done, maybe by Tuesday. Maybe I'll have time Tuesday. Just to plan out the month of March, and I think I'm gonna keep it very clean and simple, like this one. This one was just giant squares, pretty washy, and some mild liner accents. I really liked this one. And knowing what I know now, what's most effective to me, most effective for me from my personal planner system, I'm just gonna carry some of those tricks over, like using an empty circle for a bill that's due, but then like coloring in the circle once it's done, and planning ahead like birthdays or some sort of thing, since this Calendex I've made is pretty much just academic with work thrown in. But I really like this system. It's working for me at the moment. Not to say that it's going to work for me all of the times, but at least for this quarter, it's really working out. And also, I don't know if you know this, but, oh man, I think my light bulb's about to die. Sorry about that, guys. You can do that. You can do that while you're at home or whatever. Just have the band wrapped around your page. I don't know why I didn't think of this before, why it never came to me, but man, that is super helpful. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I know this was a long one. Felt like I had to catch you up on some stuff. And I know with the whole monetization thing that's happening with smaller creators, and there's such debate going, or not so much debate, just more outcry, because it seems like it's really messing with our potential creative output when you're not supported, monetarily anyways. I never hit the threshold for transferring the money that I've made to my bank. I think you have to hit $100 and then you'll finally actually see the money transferred to your account. I never really hit that. So I wasn't really affected. Again, this is my hobby, so I'm gonna still try to make videos as often as I can on the subjects that I care about, like pen reviews, planning, notebooks, all that fun stuff. And I hope you'll join me for the ride, and I will support your smaller channels too. So if you leave me a comment with something just a little bit more than, hey, subscribe or whatever, because I think that labels it as spam, I'll check out your channel and subscribe too, because I know we all have a limit to get to now, and it's a little outrageous considering our little niche we've built here. I think this is going to be the next pen I review. It's a Jetstream, but it's westernized, definitely westernized, and I got it from Amazon pretty inexpensively. It was like $6 for a pack of five, but they're like black infused ink, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, I'll continue to put out stuff and support those who do as well. And I just hope you have a really awesome day. And thank you so much for watching.